Okay, Groundhog Day, February 2nd, 2015. I did this once before, but I'm going to make sure I get a good recording of this time. This is my solar generator. Right here. It's taking 60%. It says, I can't really read that. Battery level 60%. It should be full. I charged it about 2 days ago and let it sit. Done it in the past, but I let it sit for a year almost and pull it out once in a great while. I should have been doing this at least once a week, once a month. But I've got that freezer, as you can see, plugged into the front of it. And at 9:45, quarter to 10, I don't even remember what I said the time was when I was looking at it. This is pulling from here. We'll see how long I can let this go before this says low. I did it done this already twice for like an hour or two each time. So if I can do this for 2 to 4 hours a day, 3 times a month, that should cut the electric bill by about $5, $10 maybe. Maybe even more. But it's a solar generator, the 1800. I don't know if it's saying there. Oh, power source 1800. Solutions from science. Plus, I got $100 worth of heirloom seeds for 10 years. And this is my third year. I just got the second half of my load, my second half of my order, 3 days ago. So, good deal all the way around. So, again, we'll see how long this will last like this. And I'll make a second video. This will be solar generator use part one, and I'll do solar generator use part two with the actual time from 9:45 until whenever this goes weak. See how long. But now, see, without the sun, because it's overcast, while you do have power, you can plug it into an outlet and charge it up. And it varies on the time, 2 to 4 hours, 2 to 8 hours, I believe, to charge it. And then it's fully charged, and you can run something on it, and then, like I said, you got all that excess of power that you save. So anyway, we'll see how long it takes.